Hi students, all of you, good morning. Welcome to my class. Today we are going to discuss the topic oxidation of alcohols. Right, what is meant by oxidation? Addition of oxygen is called oxidation. Otherwise, removal of hydrogen is called oxidation. Removal of electrons is called oxidation. Or increase in the oxidation number, increase in the oxidation number is called oxidation. So all these are studied in the first PUC. The chapter is stoichiometry or stoichiometry. So in the stoichiometry chapter, you studied what is an oxidation reaction, what is a reduction reaction, right? To carry the oxidation reactions, what is required? Oxidizing agents are required. The oxidizing agents are classified into two types: strong oxidizing agents and weak or mild oxidizing agents. Examples for strong oxidizing agents are acidified potassium permanganate, KMnO4, called as potassium permanganate, or potassium dichromate, K2CR2O7, called as potassium dichromate. Very, very important. Please remember this one. Either acidified potassium permanganate or acidified potassium dichromate is used as strong oxidizing agent, whereas mild or weak oxidizing agents are chromic anhydride. If you take the chromic acid, from the chromic acid, by removing the water, we will get CrO3. That CrO3 is called as chromic anhydride or chromic oxide. Right, one more thing. PCC. PCC means pyridium chlorochromate. Once again, PCC means pyridium chlorochromate. PDC. PDC means pyridium dichromate. These two are very important. In the CET and NEET, we will see some bits regarding this strong oxidizing agents and mild oxidizing agents. So today's our topic is oxidation of alcohols. Right, my dear students, we studied the preparation of alcohols in the very starting of this chapter. In the very starting of this chapter, we studied about the preparation of alcohols from Grignard reagent. We studied the preparation of alcohols from Grignard reagent. Just I am remembering to all of you, by using Grignard reagent, when the Grignard reagent, that is RMGX, is going to react with formaldehyde. Formaldehyde. What is formaldehyde? HCHY is called as formaldehyde. What will be the product? The product is, what will be the product? The product is first degree alcohol. So whenever the Grignard reagent is going to react with formaldehyde, what is obtained? First degree alcohol is obtained. First degree alcohols are represented as RCH2OH. And the Grignard reagent reacting with acetaldehyde formula, CH3C double bond O single bond H, acetaldehyde. And my dear students, acetaldehyde is an example of aldehyde with alpha hydrogens. This is the aldehyde group. C double bond O single bond H is the aldehyde group, and it is the functional group. Functional group adjacent carbon. The functional group adjacent carbon is called as alpha carbon. So acetaldehyde is having alpha carbon. Alpha carbon is having hydrogens. They are called as alpha hydrogens. So acetaldehyde is having alpha hydrogens. So whenever Grignard reagent reacting with an aldehyde that is going to contain alpha hydrogens, then we will get, what we will get? We will get second degree alcohols. Second degree alcohols are represented as, the second degree alcohols are represented as RCHOH single bond R.
So it is the preparation of first degree alcohols, second degree alcohols. So to prepare the first degree alcohols, Grignard reagent is going to react with formaldehyde. And in the formaldehyde, this is the functional group. Functional group adjacent carbon. There is no adjacent carbon to the functional group. In the case of formaldehyde, there is no adjacent carbon to the functional group. So formaldehyde is not having, formaldehyde is not having alpha carbon. Whereas acetaldehyde is having alpha carbon. This is alpha carbon and alpha carbon is having hydrogens. So all these are studied in the last preparation of alcohols. And one more reaction. When Grignard reagent is going to react with Grignard reagent is going to react with acetone. What is acetone? What is the acetone? CH3, C double bond O, single bond CH3 is called as acetone. So when Grignard reagent is going to react with ketones, when the Grignard reagent is going to react with ketones, what will be the product? The product is tertiary alcohols. Tertiary alcohols. The tertiary alcohols are represented as, the tertiary alcohols are represented as C, single bond R, single bond R, single bond R, single bond OH. Simply we can write 1, 2, 3. That is R3COH. My dear students, if you observe, tertiary alcohol, functional group attached to carbon. This is the alpha carbon. Whether this alpha carbon is having any alpha hydrogens or not. In the tertiary alcohol, this is alpha carbon. Whether this alpha carbon is having any alpha hydrogens or not. Text me your answer. Yes, very good. So finally, it is all about preparation of alcohols from Grignard reagent. This is important for 3 marks. Please try to practice. So that is all about preparation of alcohols. Now, our topic is oxidation of alcohols. Today's topic is oxidation of alcohols. How many types of alcohols are there? 3 types of alcohols are there. First degree alcohols, second degree alcohols, and third degree alcohols. I am taking first degree alcohol. The general formula of first degree alcohol is R single bond CH2 single bond OH. When the first degree alcohol is undergoing oxidation, here the oxidation means removal of hydrogen atoms. Here the oxidation is the removal of hydrogen atoms. These 2 hydrogen atoms are going to be removed from first degree alcohol. Then we will get R single bond C, double bond O, single bond H. So what is the compound? C double bond OH is called as, C double bond OH is called as aldehyde. So whenever first degree alcohols are undergoing oxidation in the presence of mild oxidizing agents, in the presence of mild or weak oxidizing agents, what we can use? We can use CrO3, chromium oxide, or we can use PCC, pyridium chlorochromate, or we can use PDC, pyridium dichromate. Very, very important one for CET and NEET. Just remember, when the first degree alcohols are undergoing oxidation in the presence of mild oxidizing agents like CrO3 or PCC or PDC, then removal of hydrogens, 2 hydrogens, that is dehydrogenation. Removal of hydrogen is called as, removal of hydrogens is called as dehydrogenation. The dehydrogenation reactions, nothing but removal of hydrogen atoms. The reactions are the examples of oxidation reactions. So simply we can say that the dehydrogenation reactions are the examples of oxidation reactions. When the first degree alcohol is undergoing dehydrogenation, or the first degree alcohol is undergoing oxidation in the presence of mild oxidizing agents, then the first degree alcohols are giving aldehydes, right? What about a strong oxidizing agents? So when the first degree alcohols, when the first degree alcohols are undergoing oxidation, when the first degree alcohols are undergoing oxidation in the presence of mild oxidizing agents like PCC, PDC, or CrO3, we are getting the aldehyde RC double bond O single bond H. This is the aldehyde. Okay. Now the same first degree alcohol RCH2OH. The first degree alcohol, when it is undergoing oxidation in presence of strong oxidizing agents, in the presence of strong oxidizing agents, example is acidified potassium permanganate. That is a strong oxidizing agent. First of all, the primary alcohol is going to give aldehydes R single bond, C double bond O single bond H. C double bond O single bond H, the compounds are called as aldehydes. So whenever the primary alcohols are undergoing oxidation, first they give aldehydes. If the aldehyde is further undergoing oxidation, is further undergoing oxidation in the presence of strong oxidizing agent, here the strong oxidizing agent taken is acidified potassium permanganate. Now here, from this one to this one, that is from first degree alcohol to formation of aldehyde, what is happening? Removal of two hydrogens are happening. Removal of hydrogens is called as dehydrogenation. Of course, the dehydrogenation is also known as oxidation. Whereas the aldehyde formed again undergoing oxidation in the presence of acidified potassium permanganate. Now, oxidation means addition of oxygen. That is R single bond C double bond O, R single bond C double bond O, addition of oxygen. Here, between carbon and hydrogen, addition of oxygen is taking place. Now, what is the name of the compound? Single bond C double bond O single bond H. What is the name of the compound? What is the name of the functional group? Yes, carboxylic acids. Very, very, very important topic for PU and NEET. So please take the screenshot. So primary alcohols undergoing oxidation in the presence of mild oxidizing agents, they give only aldehydes. Whereas primary alcohols are undergoing oxidation in the presence of strong oxidizing agents like acidified potassium permanganate or acidified potassium dichromate, first the primary alcohols are going to give aldehydes, and the aldehydes further undergoes oxidation, they are going to give carboxylic acids. So this is about oxidation of first degree alcohols in the presence of strong oxidizing agents and in the presence of weak oxidizing agents and in the presence of strong oxidizing agents. Yes, take the screenshot. Now, regarding NEET and CET, the question asked is, whenever the primary alcohol is taken and it is undergoing oxidation in the presence of strong oxidizing agent, what will be the product? Yes, of course, carboxylic acid is the product. But in the options, what they give? First option, single bond OH. Second option, single bond NH2. Third option, single bond NO2. And the fourth option, single bond COOH. For the NEET level, the questions will be asked like this. When the primary alcohols are undergoing oxidation in the presence of strong oxidizing agent, what will be the product? And the options are like that. First option, second option, third option, fourth option. Then the option should be fourth option, carboxylic acid. COOH compounds are called as carboxylic acids. And one more thing, when the primary alcohol is undergoing oxidation in the presence of strong oxidizing agent, Which type of carboxylic acids will be obtained? Which type of carboxylic acids will be obtained? Here, alcohol is having, primary alcohol is having how many carbons? 1 and 2. Because alkyl group also contains carbon. The alkyl group also contains carbon. So primary alcohol is having how many carbons? 1 and 2 carbons. And the obtained carboxylic acid. The obtained carboxylic acid is having how many carbons? The obtained carboxylic acid is having how many carbons? The obtained carboxylic acid is having how many carbons? Yes. This is the carbon in the carboxylic acid. And the alkyl group is nothing but carbon. My dear student, alkyl group is also there. Alkyl group also contains carbon. So here one carbon is there. And the alkyl group also contains one carbon. So total carboxylic acid is going to contain 2 carbons. Primary alcohol is also containing 2 carbons. Means when the primary alcohols are undergoing oxidation in the presence of strong oxidizing agents, the primary alcohols are going to give carboxylic acids with same number of carbon atoms. Write down the statement. Please write down the statement. The statement is important for CET and NEET. So the statement for CET and NEET. Here the statement is, first degree alcohols on oxidation with strong oxidizing agents. SOA means strong oxidizing agents. So when the first degree alcohols are undergoing oxidation with strong oxidizing agents, they give carboxylic acid with same number of carbon atoms. They give the carboxylic acid with same number of carbon atoms. Very, very important concept or synopsis. Please try to understand and remember. Please take the screenshot if anybody is not writing the notes. Yes, this is all about oxidation of first degree alcohols or primary alcohols. So primary alcohols on oxidation with mild oxidizing agents, what will be the product? Text me your answer. Primary alcohols on oxidation with mild oxidizing agents, what will be the product? Yes, correct. Aldehydes are the products. Yes, correct. Okay, coming to the second one, oxidation of second degree alcohols. The general formula of second degree alcohols or secondary alcohols is R single bond CH single bond OH single bond R. And the second degree alcohols are less easily undergoing oxidation because of the more number of alkyl groups, the secondary alcohols are less readily undergoing oxidation. And again here, what is happening? Removal of hydrogens is called as dehydrogenation. Removal of hydrogen is called as dehydrogenation. Of course, it is also known as oxidation. Then, between the carbon and oxygen, single bond becomes double bond. What will be the product? Text me your answer. What is the product? When the second degree alcohols is undergoing oxidation in the presence of mild oxidizing agents, second degree alcohols on oxidation gives what? They give? Yes, they give the ketones. Ketones general formula R single bond C double bond O single bond R is the general formula of ketones. So primary alcohols can undergo oxidation with mild oxidizing agents and strong oxidizing agents. But second degree alcohols can undergo only oxidation with mild oxidizing agents but not with strong oxidizing agents due to the presence of excess of alkyl groups. So secondary alcohols can give only ketones, whereas first degree alcohols can give aldehydes as well as carboxylic acids, right? Yes, take the screenshot. Yes, everything is available in your NCERT textbook. To get more knowledge regarding NEET and CET, first you have to understand the basic concepts properly. So without having any proper basics, you can never get proper idea regarding the MCQs. So first of all the students are requested, please go through the NCERT textbook, try to understand each and every line. If you are having any doubt, please call me between 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. excluding the holidays. Right, this is about second degree alcohols. My dear students, tell me, among the first degree and second degree alcohols, which are more readily undergoing oxidation? Among the first degree and second degree alcohols, which are readily undergoing oxidation? Yes, first degree alcohols are readily undergoing oxidation because of less number of alkyl groups. So then we can understand that during the oxidation of alcohols, as the number of alkyl groups increases, during the oxidation of alcohols, as the number of alkyl groups increases, the rate of oxidation or the feasibility of oxidation, get decreases. Now coming to third degree alcohols. The third degree alcohols are represented as C single bond R, single bond R, single bond R, single bond OH. Yes, tell me whether this reaction is possible or not. Whether the third degree alcohols can undergo oxidation or not. Simply you can understand, this is the first degree alcohol. And this is the second degree alcohol. Just observe carefully. First degree alcohol, alcohol attached carbon is having hydrogen atoms. So removal of hydrogen is possible. And second degree alcohol, alcohol attached carbon is having hydrogen. That is, dehydrogenation is possible. But in the case of third degree alcohols, the alcohol attached carbon is not having hydrogen. Hence, third degree alcohols, yes, you have to text me. Third degree alcohols do not undergo oxidation. Once again, the third degree alcohols do not undergo oxidation because the alcohol attached carbon is not having hydrogen. Whereas in the first degree alcohols, alcohol attached carbon having hydrogens. Second degree alcohols, alcohol attached carbon is having hydrogen. But in the case of third degree alcohols, alcohol attached carbon is having no hydrogen. So which type of alcohol, CET bit, which type of alcohol cannot undergo oxidation? Yes, the bit is which type of alcohol cannot undergo oxidation? This is the bit. So here the options is, first option, CH3, CH2, OH, ethyl alcohol. Second option, CH3, CHOH, CH3. This is the second option. And the third option is CH3 taken thrice OH, third option. And the fourth option is CH3, CHOH, CH2, CH3. See the options carefully, take the screenshot. Later you have to send the answer. Don't text the answer. After the completion of the class, you have to answer. Among these alcohols, which alcohol is not undergoing oxidation? Yes, once again, take the screenshot. So this is all about oxidation of alcohols. Now, one more point. Oxidation is nothing but dehydrogenation. My dear students, at the end of the class, please send me the attendance. Sorry, not the dehydration. not the dehydration, dehydrogenation. Dehydrogenation. Now I am taking three types of alcohols. That is first degree alcohol, R single bond CH2 single bond OH. Second degree alcohol, RCH single bond OH single bond R. And third degree alcohol, C single bond CH3 single bond CH3 single bond CH3 single bond OH. So three types of, wait a minute, three types of alcohols are taken: first degree alcohol, second degree alcohol, and third degree alcohol. And first degree alcohol is passed through hot copper metal. The copper metal is taken at a temperature of 573 kelvins. Second degree alcohol is passed through hot copper metal at a temperature of 573 kelvins. And the third degree alcohol is passed through copper metal at a temperature of 573 kelvins. What they observed is here removal of two hydrogens is taking place. Removal of two hydrogens, that is going to give R single bond C double bond OH. Here second degree alcohol, removal of two hydrogens is going to take place. What is going to be obtained? R single bond C double bond O single bond R. So in the case of first reaction and second reaction, what is happening? Removal of hydrogen atoms is happening. Removal of hydrogen atoms is called as dehydrogenation. Once again, the removal of hydrogen atoms is called as dehydrogenation. Dehydrogenation is nothing but oxidation. Once again, dehydrogenation is nothing but oxidation. So what can undergo oxidation? First degree alcohols can undergo oxidation. Second degree alcohols can undergo oxidation. But here the oxidation is particularly dehydrogenation. So we can say that first degree alcohols on dehydrogenation by passing through copper metal at higher temperature, that gives aldehydes as the products. Second degree alcohol by passing through copper metal on dehydrogenation, that gives ketones. So these two reactions are the examples of dehydrogenation reactions and oxidation reactions. What about tertiary alcohol? The tertiary alcohol is not undergoing dehydrogenation. The tertiary alcohols are undergoing dehydration. Once again, the tertiary alcohols, they are undergoing dehydration. Right. How the dehydration is going to happen? In the case of tertiary alcohol? So simply we can say that the tertiary alcohols are not undergoing oxidation, means the tertiary alcohols are not undergoing dehydrogenation. The tertiary alcohol is undergoing dehydration. The tertiary alcohol is undergoing dehydration. This is the tertiary alcohol. Because alcohol attached carbon is attached with three carbons. Once again, alcohol group attached with three carbons. So this carbon is the third degree carbon. Hence this alcohol is the tertiary alcohol. Now what is going to happen? When the tertiary alcohol is passed through copper metal at a temperature of 573 kelvins, here removal of OH minus ion and removal of H plus ion is going to happen. So removal of OH minus ion and H plus ion, what is going to get removed? Water molecule is going to get removed. Removal of water is called as dehydration. So dehydration of third degree alcohols is happening. Just a minute. Yes, thank you. So dehydration of alcohols is, tertiary alcohol is happening. Then what do you observe? Between CH2 and H, this bond is there. This bond is going to migrate between carbon and carbon. Between carbon and carbon, single bond becomes as a double bond. Then we will write the product C single bond CH3. This is the one. C single bond CH3. Yes, now tell me. between C and CH2, single bond becomes double bond. That is double bond CH2. Double bond. Double bond is known as, that is an alkene. So what is going to obtain? When the tertiary alcohols are undergoing dehydration, they are going to give alkenes. So you can understand that first degree and second degree alcohols can undergo dehydrogenation. Once again, my statement, first degree and second degree alcohols can undergo dehydrogenation to give aldehydes and ketones respectively, whereas third degree alcohols cannot undergo dehydrogenation. The third degree alcohols can undergo only dehydration to give the corresponding alkenes. So this is all about oxidation of alcohols. In the next class, we will study about another topic, phenols. Right, and one more point is there. Very less time is there. In the next class, I will discuss about alcohols. One more topic, little bit, small topic is there. The time is less than 2 minutes, 1 minute, 21 seconds is there. Yes, please text me whether the class is understood to you or not. Please text me in the chat box whether the class is understood to you or not. All the students must respond. All the students must respond. Don't leave the class. Until the session is going to complete, don't leave the class. And to understand a little bit more, I request, please read the NCERT textbook. Don't leave the class, please. And if you are having any doubt, you can call me between 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. Every day I'm saying, but no student is calling me regarding their doubts. So please send me the attendance screenshot if you took that one. Yes, thank you for watching my video lectures. Thank you one and all. Stay home.